Hey everyone, first video for a long time, so we'll go back to something, back to the basics, more for me than anything else. Still the same palette, except it's split. Oops. Cobalt blue, Pentel terrain, brown madder, royal and yellow, some sort of bright yellow and turquoise. And without much further ado, I'll just crack on. Just a landscape, one of my normal ish things. I'll suggest some sort of building. See what that looks like. Might just leave that. Cameras making funny noises. Just remnants of my palette. These colours, never clean them. Lovely start for the sky. That's like a greeny grey, so. Just hold the brush for the tip end. Just scrub away. Do you want to try and complete this sky? All wet. Tape I've got is not very good. Just a mixture of your blues, yellows, and your red. A little bit of white paper as well. The quicker you do it, the fresher it'll look. The quicker you do it, the more time it looks you've spent on it. And always go it a bit darker. So it will dry lighter. Just a different bunch of greys really. Just use me greys mixing opposites on the palette. Reds and turquoise, blues and a bit of orange. That looks on the palette, it comes out greenish, I'll put some red in. Let's have some bright yellowy in the middle of that there somewhere. Coming down all the time, I think, on some lips. A little bit darker with this cloud. Still wet. That's quite a nice colour, that. A bit of it down there. Let's look at that, with the little white bit in the shape of a house. But I want to go a bit further down with the horizon. This is all still wet. A nice purple colour. Probably a bit like that. Try and leave that broken edge. These are just mixtures of basically brown madder, ultramarine and cobalt blue. Just different strengths of each. Don't ask me what percentage one is. I'll have a clue. It all mixes on the paper anyway. Don't really want any drips. I'll have to keep my eye on that. get me the yellows and the ochres. Have something really quite bright. At the same time going into this is too light, all this. Didn't really want that. Going a bit darker, a bit stronger as you come to the bottom. This is my first painting for 6 weeks. Not always a bad thing. Especially if I've been working 18 hours a day for the past 6 weeks. Background's gone really pale, but leave the foreground to paint itself. I bottled out with that background a bit. That's going to drip. Probably still will. I might as well get the other one. See? That foreground's looking after itself. Ow! It's just cloud if it doesn't appear to be a mountain. No cloud. It's still wet, the base is still wet, so it's all going to paint itself. And these are just Chinese calligraphy brushes. Brilliant for watercolours. That drips. I'll do that, come back to haunt me, but it doesn't matter. A little bit darker on this side. So, a bit of spatter. Once this mountain's in, you've got your foreground, your background, a bit of mid-ground. You only want a bit of suggestion of buildings or cattle. The painting's nearly done. I like the way that blue on top of the mountain. We can always, that's sort of the sun, get the light coming from there. Shame. I can do something with that. That one drip. Just leave that. You just dipped nonsense, rubbish.
Yeah.
Breathe out as well. Come back in a bit. In a bit. Right, we're back after about 5 minutes. I don't really want this to dry totally. Get some dark, get some more blue out. Oh. Put some background trees. No suggestion of. Well, that's still damp. Might be a bit dry up there, because you'll get some sharp edges up top. Fuzzy at the bottom. Mush. That's a bit green. I just want it totally dark, not the colour. Just something to break that monotony up. Is it getting nearly dry now? Yeah. New leaves. Or birds. Right. I'm looking at this part now. Light patch developed there. I might use that and pretend it's a roof. So, that's how I'm going to do it. That doesn't look like a roof, does it? Hey. I don't know, what do you do? Change that. That's nice then. The trees have come out quite nice. Let's just do some more, I think. I always leave white bits. I'll get a bit of tissue. I paint a bit of tissue as well. It's not painting, it's not just playing stuff, it's taking stuff, things up as well. Just have a tatty brush. There we are, sharp edges. As I say, it's going back to basic. Now we can maybe able to paint around something. A little building there. Yeah, the first one I did just looked too big. That could be anything. What if we do a bit of detail? On here. I got a little house there. Nothing to. It's a bit outside. So I'll give him a mate. Ish. Okay. Oops, that's a bit too. If that was there, it'd be okay. Nah, I'll just leave it. Don't be. Just trees, isn't it? No mountains in this one. These are all drying at different rates now.
That's better, that, isn't it?
So it's just a sky, foreground, mid-ground and some detail. But I will. Flat brush, dry brush. Some of my cows. Don't know if that dry brush is needed. I'm waffling again. But hopefully able to watch the video, not to listen to me. Too self-explanatory really. But I'll just let that dry again. And a bit of detail. You're not far off done for a little, like starter watercolour. Be back in a bit when that's dry. Because your last bits, I do like to get sharp edges on them. In a bit. I'm virtually straight back. Got a little, I think I was in a travelling set years ago, a little big brush. But it's brilliant for doing these little details. Cattle and just bits. So hopefully the illness will bring the piece together a bit better. Where all that's foreground, midground, background, just link them together with suggestion of some life. So we've got to decide where we're going to have the main one, yeah? And I've done one there, I've just painted round his belly, the white belly. But we do need a main one. Might be a bit blue now. I'm going to put a bit of white in. Just needs one main protagonist. The word for the day. That's a nice dark blue that, but there's not much of that in the painting, but it's looking a bit standalone. Which sometimes is not a bad thing, but he's not going to be my main character. I don't know. When I look at it without my glasses, it doesn't look right. I'm going to do that. Nice little cow in the mist.
Yeah,
a lot of it, just let it paint itself. And one big one, I'll just try it from here. Not too big. Don't have it. On. That's, I don't know, that looks like some creature, mixture between a pig and a cow. But it sort of works. Don't. I've never studied veterinary practices. Oops. A bit of reflection. I'm thinking it does need something there now. Possibly. And some gates or bits. Don't mess about with it too much. I just need something here. Suggestion for the building. That building took about 10 seconds. Once that's dry again. I might do it now. I will get me... I use a little lavender colour, if I can find it. And I'll get it in the way. He says. I've got a little tube of lavender. It just brings a bit out. And I use lavender and white at the very end. I should wait for this to dry, really. So I'll come back when it's dry, see if I can find my paints. Right, I'll come back almost straight away again. I found my lavender. It's just, you probably won't see it. It's just bits. Because that's still wet, that'll bleed into it. And it just adds a bit of variation. But I don't want it too bitty. And I'll get me white. And really, I just want to go there and the highlight of that main cow pig, whatever you said it was. And a bit round the middle bit. Yep. Thick paint for this. Sometimes it's best to pour this out first and let it dry off a bit because you're getting all the moisture at the top. Just tiny bits of suggestion. Well, this is a domain one, but I don't want too much paint on it. I don't want it to be too big. Start with that. And a blob on the bottom. Somewhere. You know what, I think we're done. And so we'll take the tape off, as we always do. Need some new tape. This is probably seeped under this. Tape at the bottom. Gives it a nice edge, normally, with proper tape. So I work on building sites a lot. The decorators, so we'll leave half a roll behind most sites, but I think they've left this roll behind on purpose. It's not very good. Just medium tack. If this comes off in a straight edging out, we can make it look frame and mount it, but see, it's just a. The sky was nothing. We're sort of getting darker as we're coming through the foreground, the background. So the sky, foreground, background, painting one. A little country scene. When things are dry, goes in a straight line. It'll look like a finished painting, but it's not finished. So once it's dry, I'll just go back into it, but not be much, just sharpen the edges up. And hopefully, you can see it's not too bad. Just have a go. It's my first painting for a while, so hopefully be posting some more. So, have a go, everybody. Take care. Bye.